Greetings! I'm Shad! That's right, check it out! The Shadiversity plushie is now available! It's available! We got an official Shadiversity plushie! Look at this guy! This is a very accurate depiction! They're available for a very limited time, so you can get one or secure your one now on Makeship. Link in the description. And why would you not want a Shadiversity plushie? It's so cute! Check it! I don't know why. He looks very handsome.
Welcome back to The Watch, and today we're going to be talking about The Witcher, specifically the remake that's currently in the works.
Hang on.
Of The Witcher 1.
There's a remake?
Yeah, a remake of the first game.
Of the first game?
Yeah.
Okay, so this isn't like a remake of the TV show or anything, so the remake.
Not yet.
Okay.
We'll stay updated on that, but currently we're just talking about the games, specifically the first one, because it came out quite a while ago now.
It is, yeah, a bit dated.
So they're going to be remaking it, and there's some interesting stuff going on here. So let's get into it. What do you think, Nathan?
Well,
because I think Nathan knows more about this.
But before, because I'm probably the least, you know, read on this subject then.
Foreshadowing. Makes sense in a little bit.
It'll make sense later.
You say your things, Chad.
It better. I was just going to say, like, in terms of my thoughts, just hearing from, like, CD Projekt Red is not what it used to be.
Yep.
And they've embraced CSG, which means social governance thingy. And I'd be worried they'd be injecting a lot of woke messaging and propaganda, because that's what they've signed on to do.
Well, all right. So before
you're jumping the gun here.
Yeah, well, you are jumping
the gun.
All right. So first up, there's been a couple of like quotes from developers and stuff like that, basically saying they want to change things for a modern audience.
Nice.
Now,
red flag.
Yes, but hold your horses here. With some of these older games, and something like Dark Souls pops right into my mind for something like this. Play something like Dark Souls 1. Some of those boss runs, some of the game designs and mechanics are just terrible. They're just not fun, right? So I can understand if you were going to change some of those mechanics of an older game to make it more fun, and so you don't have to do some of that grindy stuff. If it's that sort of stuff...
But that's not what they mean when they say for a modern audience. It's never that.
I'm just playing devil's
advocate. No. Like, you know what they could say when they're saying that? We want to improve some game mechanics. But when they say update for a modern audience, that is explicitly about the sensitivities of easily offended, outraged mob.
Okay, well, we'll tell you the thing that they've said they're going to change, and you can tell us whether or not you think it should be changed.
Okay.
So what they are going to be removing, in the original game, whenever you slept with one of the NPC characters, afterward you would get a player card of them in a somewhat
revealing,
you know, a little play card for later. And the creators who've made this themselves have said afterwards, yeah, I kind of regret making that. That was a bit weird, you know. So that's what they've mentioned. They're probably going to remove that mechanic.
Okay, that's hard for me to comment on.
Why?
You can literally comment on everything in existence, but you draw your line there.
Because I have different standards about this.
Okay.
I think for a general audience, guys that just like, you know,
sexy
stuff in their games probably would have an issue with it. I think sexy stuff can go too far. I'm against, you know, over-sexualization in that sense. For me, I would have a different view as opposed to most people on this one specifically.
So I'm on the same boat with you. I think it's fine if they remove that. Mm-hmm. Other things I was saying as well, they're going to make it less linear. There's more open world stuff to it that they're adding it. I'm guessing because of newer games, people probably played Witcher 3, not Witcher 1. So that stuff all makes sense.
Okay.
However, like you were saying before, Shad, CD Projekt Red have said some things.
Yes.
That when they say, have said some things in the past that are... You know, saying modern audience, you kind of go, well, that's associated with other things on the internet.
Like, hold on, let's just check what the comments say here.
What's that?
where did that come from? Shocking! Shocking!
We were doing our research, and it turns out you did it before us! You're a year early to
this. I am. This is a year old comment right there.
And that's the top one as well on
well,
the video.
You know why? Oh, no, that's your login.
Yeah.
My comment is at the top. What the heck?
It's at the top. Yeah. It's the most liked with the most comments. Or not
no,
most
no,
comments,
it's not the most liked.
It's one of the highest ranked.
It's the highest ranked. Probably because you're verified as well.
Yeah. Maybe. That could be it. What do people say? Like, well, Shannon, if you love your content, Shannon.
So we laughed at this too when we found this because
I feel you. Okay, so I've been read on some of the stuff that's been going on.
So basically the CFO of CD Projekt Red were like, we're part of the ESG now, we're gonna, report to them, are part of, government initiatives. Yeah. If you don't know about it, look it up and you'll realize that it's all connected.
It is all connected.
It's all about values and culture and making sure that the message...
And when a company does that, it shows you what their priorities are.
Yeah.
And on so many levels, it means that they are actually wanting to be regressive in terms of certain things that we have been achieving in society, pushing horrible work propaganda and hate many traditional values that I feel is very... So when I say, if a company does this, they're dead to me, basically. Okay. Mm. The only caveat I would make to something like this is that we have seen rare examples, but it has happened, where a spokesperson says something insanely woke and retarded about their show or whatever, and when it comes out, it doesn't have any of that in. House of the Dragons is that.
The CFO is different, though.
This is true.
That's very high up.
The CFO is high up. Yeah, so... We tackle the issues of domestic violence. Oh, I can't even bother with that.
Yeah, so... That's what we're saying. Even though right now what they're saying seems, okay, that makes sense in terms of mechanics.
Well, that's the thing. Yeah. If you're talking specifically about game mechanics that are like very outdated and are kind of boring today, I have no problem with that sort of stuff. It's just removing... It's like GTA 5. Every time they update it, they remove jokes and this and that. It's like, I don't want any of that.
And it's just to say, modern audience can mean game mechanics, but also mean, story elements and the way that they push certain messages.
I mean, we talked about this with Netflix Avatar, that they're removing some of the sexism. And it was comedy. Like, are you telling me that a cartoon from... When was it made?
2004
is too edgy... For our current modern audience, are we that soft that you can't even handle a cartoon? Really?
And it's also crazy because going back to a more recent example in Suicide Squad, more things have come out about that. The bios of all the characters. Have you seen that?
I've heard some of them.
Oh, it is. Lex Luthor would never call anyone a crazy billionaire or insufferable misogynist or, Wonder Woman, they say, she left this beautiful society of womanhood and, joined this manhood of, these crazy people. Maybe she's actually a bad person for doing that. Maybe she's the bad one that was cast out into this awful world. Like, it's baffling to me that they would...
They ripped paragraphs of her Wonder Woman in Suicide Squad. Her character cards.
Yeah.
It's like toxic masculinity, crazy billionaire. It's funny because Lex Luthor, the bad guy, is talking how they talk in real life. A bad guy.
Yeah.
It's insane. Anyways, back to the...
But the thing I'm saying, if that's happening right now in Suicide Squad, what's going to happen in a few years when the remakes come out with this?
And I mean, again, compare the quality of the Arkham games compared to now. That goes to show you, even if it bears the same studio name, if it doesn't have the same people working on this, it's not the same studio. And so I wonder how many changes have happened internally with CD Projekt Red. And now that they are doing the ESG crap...
And a bad game release can sink a studio. We had this with Saints Row, when they they did what Suicide Squad is doing, and it can sink studios.
Yeah.
So,
what a great example to follow, Suicide Squad model, Saints Row, just get completely woke, subvert the entire thing for woke propaganda. That seems to work out great. So, look, we haven't seen it come out yet. Okay. So what they're saying here, it could just be game mechanics, though. I wonder if, they might have been seeing some writing on the wall. People are hating the woke stuff, and so they're just not announcing any of it. And when it comes out, it'll all be in the game. And this could be a deflection that it's, oh, sure, it's just game mechanics stuff.
Red flags, though.
It's very early to tell, but I think the writing's already on the wall because of just because we're getting the next Switcher game before we're getting this one, and so that'll also tell us the direction they're going in. Because we're not going to have Geralt in this next one, so.
You know, like people say, don't judge, not out yet. But it's the whole meme of when you see a dog squatting to push out a crap.
And that's the point now, Shad, where we haven't had a single good thing come out in a while. Like, it's very rare for it. We're more right than we are wrong now.
This is true.
Like,
this is true.
Like, even God of War Valhalla, the DLC came out, which is great. But it gives me red flags because it's like, oh, I feel like the next game is going to be an Atreus game or something I don't want.
So, they're going to take
even when
the
I get something
male
good,
character
I kind
out.
Of go, oh no, no, no.
It's a send off, you know.
Well, that's the current state of what's looking like with The Witcher. We'll see what happens when it comes out because we'll be staying on watch.